Hello, I'm Carrie Gardner. I'm an LPC here at Walter's Walk. And I'd like to tell you about a tool that I use in my sessions called the Enneagram. It really promotes growth and self-awareness. The Enneagram is a personality typology with ancient roots. It's unlike other personality assessments, though, in that it doesn't stop at identifying your particular personality type and then put you in a box, but it illuminates the unhealthier and limiting patterns associated with your type, and then highlights specific changes you can take towards growth and health away from those patterns. I really enjoy using the Enneagram because it's based on a premise of non-judgment and compassion towards self and towards others. So it's good to use with individuals as well as couples to foster that sense of compassion and unity. It really emphasizes how alike we all are with our differences and with our basic fears and desires. I think I also enjoy using it because it correlates with our great vision and mission here at Walter's Walk to serve the community from an attitude of compassion and non-discrimination. Here's a visual of the Enneagram. It's a geometric figure with 9 points that represent the 9 types and how they're interrelated. And just listen to these types and maybe you'll be able to pick out the one that resonates with you the most. I'll start at the top and go clockwise. Type 9 is the peacemaker. 9s desire peace within as well as in their environments. They seek inner stability and avoid conflict. In order to avoid conflict, though, 9s have the tendency to squelch their inner voice and go along with others. 9s at their healthiest understand that their voice matters and that they have something important to contribute to the world. Type 1 is the reformer. 1s desire integrity and accuracy and strive to be responsible and make a difference in life. In order to feel good enough, 1s have the tendency to hold themselves to very high standards and have harsh inner critics. 1s at their healthiest understand how to accept themselves, their circumstances, and others without judgment or fear of making a mistake. Type 2 is the helper. 2s desire to be liked and accepted by others and to maintain a positive self-image. In order to feel accepted, 2s have the tendency to meet others' needs before their own and avoid acknowledging their own and others' negative emotions. 2s at their healthiest understand the freedom that comes with self-care, allowing for more authentic generosity towards others. Type 3 is the achiever. 3s desire to succeed and are driven, charming, and often competitive. In order to feel worthwhile, 3s have the tendency to exaggerate their achievements or place too much value on impressing others. 3s at their healthiest understand their inherent value and thrive on self-acceptance apart from their accomplishments, motivating others to follow suit. Type 4 is the individualist. 4s desire to be true to themselves while viewing themselves as set apart from the crowd, and are often creative and sometimes quirky. In order to feel significant, 4s have the tendency to shift into moodiness and hold on to their feelings. 4s at their healthiest understand how to use their gift of introspection to grow versus ruminate, letting go of self-absorption in favor of self-renewal. Type 5 is the investigator. 5s desire mastery to feel capable and competent, and are often isolated observers who possess great focus and innovation. In order to feel like they understand everything, 5s have the tendency to get caught up in their own ideas, overthinking things to the point of isolation. 5s at their healthiest understand that their competency is derived from knowing themselves as separate from their environments, able to engage in life without fully understanding it. Type 6 is the loyalist. 6s desire and exhibit responsibility and trustworthiness, and often struggle with hidden anxiety. They're effective problem solvers, but they also might fear the worst. In order to feel secure and supported, 6s have the tendency to lean on others' best judgment while doubting their own. 6s at their healthiest understand that stability comes from within and learn to rely on themselves. Type 7 is the enthusiast. 7s desire spontaneity and variety, always looking for the next exciting experience, and are typically fun-loving and high-spirited. In order to feel satisfied and happy, 7s have the tendency to anticipate future adventure and stimulation and might feel bored or even depressed if nothing is on the horizon. 7s at their healthiest understand how to find joy in the assimilation of experience versus thrill-seeking. Type 8 is the challenger. Eights desire to decide their own path in life, are direct and decisive, often being looked up to by others for their self-confidence. In order to feel in control of their own destiny, eights have the tendency to attempt to control others with intimidation or confrontation. Eights at their healthiest understand that vulnerability is a path to self-protection as it allows their hearts to soften and heal. Well, those are the nine types of the Enneagram. If you'd like to learn more about it and explore it, I have two resources for you. The first one is this book, which has quizzes built into it to help you identify your type. The second resource is the Enneagram Institute's website, which also has tests on it for a small fee. Thanks for watching this video. I encourage you to check out our other videos by other providers here at Walter's Walk, and also to check out our website if you'd like to get connected to our services.